If you think that AI is everywhere and that it will take over the world and that it is the most important invention since maybe the wheel or the printing press or the steam engine or those shoes with LED lights, then you should watch this video because you might be the victim of a technological hype. This is what I want to discuss in this video. Is AI just a technological hype?
I think it'll very quickly realize that getting more control is a very good sub-goal because it helps you achieve other goals. And if these things get carried away with getting more control, we're in trouble.
There are hundreds of videos out there on what AI can do. And we have to be fair, it's pretty awesome. Due to something called deep learning, AI has made phenomenal advances in the past couple of years. It is fairly good at generating speech. It is very good at generating images, and it is quite good at generating kind of simplistic, boring music. But here's the trick. Everything I just said is technically false. AI is not good at generating speech. It is good at generating a very specific kind of speech. It is not good at generating images. It is good at generating a very specific kind of images. And the same goes for music. What happens typically is that you are given examples. Look at what AI did. Look at this text. Look at this image. And you have to say, this is quite human-like. And in some cases, it might even be better than what a human would produce. But those examples happen to be extracted from what is in fact a very limited realm. What is AI good at in terms of generating text? What are large language models, as they're called, good at? Well, patterns of text. And that includes everything from factual information to summaries to classifications and even suggestions. What are generative image models good at? Well, you guessed it, patterns of images. And this includes landscapes and objects and even patterns that we perceive as being very complicated. As long as there's a pattern there, you can throw computational power at it and you can generate many examples of that pattern. So we are given these examples and we are led to assume that the way in which they are produced, the way in which the text is generated or the way in which the image is generated or the music, is similar, if not maybe identical, to the way in which a human would. In which case it seems natural to say, well, if AI can generate this and that, then surely it can generate many other similar things. If it can generate images of tables and coffee cups and laptops, surely it can generate images of bikes.
Bikes!
If AI can draw humans dancing, then surely AI can draw humans, I don't know, tying their shoelaces. Or playing the trumpet. Or even cutting an onion.
Oh no!
But as you can see, things are not that simple. Why? Well, because the foundational models, as they're called, do not learn in the same way humans do. Let me explain. In order for models to be trained to do something, they have to be fed large batches of data. What the model does is, in essence, extracting patterns from that data. The statistics behind this are immensely complicated. But in essence, they're not very different from that regression you used in first year of statistics in order to build a model from your data. It's much more complicated, but it's the same kind of process. Once the model learns to do something, it has extracted the pattern, and then it can generate very many instances of that pattern. This is why it's almost never the same. If two people give the same prompt to, let's say, Midjourney in order to generate an image, it can generate very many combinations of details within that image. Now ask yourself, is this how you learned? Is this how you learned to read and write and speak and understand? Did you gobble up all the internet up to 2021? No. Is this how you learned to cut an onion? Did you have to go through 50 gigabytes of images of people cutting onions? This is why the learning pattern is different, and this is why the outcome is so limited. Now think about it. The developers had, in fact, a problem. We don't know how we learn. We don't know how the brain works. We do know something about it. And I think this is universally accepted. And it is this. We learn by using models. This much is clear. But they're not all language models, and they're not all image models. We don't know exactly what kind of models the brain uses. Maybe the metaphor of a model is not even appropriate for describing what happens in the brain when we learn something. So the developers took a tiny bit of truth that we could accept, which is that we learn by using models, and threw immense computational power at it in order to achieve, in some very restricted areas, similar results. And you might think, well, maybe there's more than one way to achieve the same result. My brain does it in this mysterious model-using way. Their engines do it with immense computational power. Fair enough. I'd like to suggest at the end of this video that that is unlikely, but it is not something we can demonstrate to be false. It could be that we can achieve brain-like features by using gigantic batches of data and immense computational power. There are good reasons to think that that is unlikely, but let's set that aside for now. What is important is that in the discourse around AI, we tend to use verbs and nouns, and we tend to describe what the AI is doing in human-like terms. So we say ChatGPT can give you suggestions, or ChatGPT can explain the theory of relativity. But ChatGPT is not doing any explaining. It's not doing any suggesting. ChatGPT is just doing statistics. Now, in their defense, people who describe AI like this do not really have an alternative. It would just be tedious to say all the time, well, ChatGPT is not explaining this and that. It is just generating text based on predictions that are derived from a model to which it arrived through regression and all that. Yeah, nobody talks like that. But by personifying what is happening, by using these verbs and nouns that stand for human intentionality, even leaving aside the whole question of whether AI actually understands or whether it's sentient, you know, the whole John Searle Chinese room thing, by personifying what's happening, we tend to extrapolate more easily to what it could do. We tend to forget that there are hard limits to what it can do because of the way these engines learn. So the reality is that AI sits on what is in fact a very small patch of land, and there might be hard limits on what AI can do, how much we can extend this land. Because of the way it is built, and because we're mimicking human intelligence while not really understanding how human intelligence arises, AI might never be capable of covering topics such as tacit knowledge, what we generally call experience, private knowledge, emotion, subtlety, humor, nonverbal communication, and everything you understand under nonverbal communication. So think of intonation, facial expression, phrasing, accent, everything. Spontaneity, intentional mistakes, original styles. It can copy styles, of course, because styles become patterns and we recognize them because of their pattern-like features, but it cannot come up with original styles. Sensations and bodily knowledge, everything that we don't really have words for. Movement, have you seen robots do basic stuff?
Now everything doesn't go exactly the way it's supposed to.
Vagueness and fuzziness in thought and speech, and really everything of that je ne sais quoi that cannot be modeled statistically in the way we model text and images and maybe music. So to go back to a question I raised earlier, can AI replicate what the brain is doing? The answer has to be sure. There's no reason to assume that only brains can do that. But can AI replicate what the brain is doing in the way neural networks are built nowadays? We have to say no, because as we've seen, a lot of what we do, a lot of how we understand, is not resolvable by throwing computational power at it. Most of what happens in many areas of human interaction is not, for all we can tell, achieved by crunching data and using statistical analysis and immense computational power. So next time you hear about how AI will take over the world and AI is the last technology we will ever invent and all that, Remember that we don't know the next thing about how the brain works and how actual intelligence works, and that these performances, while again amazing and admirable, are in fact achieved in a very, very small patch of land. Now, that doesn't mean they're not extremely fun, so here's a couple of images of dogs and cats dancing. Enjoy, and don't forget to subscribe.